join together in the prayer of invocation. God, Creator, who made us in His image, we come into your presence with joy, love, laughter, and longing to be surprised. We believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God, our Lord and Savior. He had the last laugh on the devil when he rose from the dead. We believe in the Holy Spirit, our counselor, our guide, our motivator. He is our joy. Forgive us, Lord, when we take ourselves too seriously, when we don't claim the happiness that is rightfully ours as your children, when we forget that you have the last laugh in this world. May we find this freedom of my laughter. There is healing and hope and abundance and blessing. Take our souls to the brush of your spirit to renew our worship and our living. Restore to us the joy of our salvation. Affirmation of faith. I believe in God, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead.
On the third day, He rose again. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the Ephesians, the forgiveness of sins,
the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen.
You know, there was a little girl was hanging out with her grandfather, and then she turned and looked at her grandfather and said, "Grandpa, did God make you?" Grandpa said, "Yeah." And then she looks, and then she asked him, "Did God make me too?" And the little grandfather said, "Yes, God made you too." And she's come closer to her grandfather, look at his face, touching his face, going around. And then after that, the grandfather was wondering, what is he thinking? She said, "You know what? I think God is doing a lot better job now than he was." A Sunday school teacher was teaching the class. And then one girl raised her hands and said, talking about Jesus' resurrection. And the little girl said, I wonder what Jesus' first word when he came out of the tomb. And then the teacher said, you know, I'm not sure because the Bible not really talk about it to explain or describe what Jesus' first word. And the little girl was sitting way in the back. She raised her head. I know. And the teacher said, okay, what is Jesus' first word? She said, when Jesus came out of the tomb, he said, ta-da! Today is Easter season. We're still continuing with this Easter season. And Jesus, we believe that Jesus resurrected from the dead, right, girls? And with that, you believe in that. We've all believed. There's one disciple, he didn't believe unless he see the nails mark on Jesus' feet and the holes of hand and the holes on his hand. So the first week, the disciples were gathered and all of a sudden Jesus was standing in the midst and they all surprised, like, wow. Jesus is risen. A week later, and do you remember who's that disciple? Was it there? Thomas. Listen to Martha. Martha say Thomas. It's Thomas. No, Judas the one that betrayed Jesus. Okay, I think we better get back to Sunday school. It's been too long. And Thomas wasn't there. Week later, Thomas was with the disciples. Jesus show up. It's going to be in our reading today. Jesus show up and Thomas said, I can't. But Thomas said to his disciples, I'm not going to believe unless I see the mark in his hands. Because remember, Jesus was nailed to the cross, right? So a week later, Thomas was with them. Jesus, all of a sudden, Jesus show up, right? In the locked door, standing in the middle, in the midst of the disciples. And Thomas said, I'm not going to believe you unless I touch you. My hands and touched my feet, my side. And Jesus said, blessed are those who believe without seeing, right? Yeah. We're here because we believe. The Bible said that Jesus resurrected from the dead. So we must believe that Jesus resurrected. And then with our faith, we got to put our trust in him, knowing that Christ is here with us. God is with us, not only here in church on Sunday, but everywhere. Amen? Mm-hmm. Amen. And another story before we continue. A young boy came to church with his parents. It was the very first time this boy being in church. I don't know what happened, but they came into church and they sit way in the front just like you. And the boy was kind of wondering what's going on. They see people hugging, singing, praying. People were dancing. He likes it. And when time to the ushers come with the plate, and he's walking around and come to their pew where they were sitting, before the father take out his wallet to put their gift in the offering plate, the little boy said, I'm so loud in the church, Dad, don't pay for me, I'm under five. So I hope you don't tell me not to pay for you because you're a child. You're in the kingdom of God and you're a child, God's child, and you belong to God's family. So we are not here to pay God, but we're here as we love God so much and we appreciate his love for you. Amen? Amen. So whatever gift that we have, we offer it to the Lord. Amen? Amen. Let us pray. Oh, gracious and loving God, thank you for your son, Jesus Christ. Bless these children and for those who are not with us today. Remind them that you are always with them no matter where they are. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Missy. We should sing that before. Okay. Now we continue our worship this morning with sharing our peace and joy, sharing our joys and concerns. Any blessing that you wanted to share with your family of knowing. Thank you, Chris.
Yes, ma'am. I'm very thankful. My granddaughter was in an accident a couple of days ago. She was rear-ended at a stoplight. The man who hit her totaled his car, but she is fine, not even a scratch. Thank you.
Yes.
Lord, in your love and mercy,
hear our prayers.
Tom?
I'm thankful that my granddaughter Miranda, the longtime friend who lives in Florida, survived her test for COVID-19, but only mild cases.
Mild cases?
Yeah.
Okay.
Lord, in your love and mercy,
hear our prayers.
Sherry?
Let's continue to keep the people in Ukraine in our prayers. They really need our help.
Lord, in your love and mercy,
hear our prayers.
Any other, Sherry? Martha?
I'm ever grateful that I'm here this Sunday, and that Debbie's friend Ed is recovering remarkably well from COVID pneumonia. He was really sickly. He's coming right along.
Lord, in your love and mercy.
The grandchildren. Jacob has recovered from a bad case of strep throat, thank you, penicillin, and he'll be joining us, and he'll be back again to be with us next week, flying back so that he can work for a while here in Reagan.
Lord, in your love and mercy. The Tongan ministry really celebrate yesterday in the patio. I have some pictures up on my Facebook. So grateful to finally celebrate in the patio with a roof on, and then we kind of stayed here until 8, and the light was working, which wasn't the last few days. So it is a blessing. It is a nice feeling to be here in our church, in our own patio, and what we wanted to do. So I want to give thanks to each and every one of you for all your prayers at the finance committee, and Alan, who's been working with the contractors, and you can imagine when the whole Adams Center is done and we get to go there after church and fellowship with. But I think last Sunday it was nice that Karen and Joyce able to have a little like refreshment with everybody, and we see everybody wanted to talk and just the fellowship after worship. So, but it is a nice feeling being here, and a lot of family and relatives that came from afar, and they really enjoy and appreciated all the work that we have done here. And we really have a good time. So thanks be to God. Good to have you, Lorna, with us again, and Lorna joined us with us yesterday to experience a Tongan celebration. That is truly a joy. Thanks be to God. Any other sharing? Okay, so let us come together and have a moment of silence, remembering those who have gone from us, absent of the body and present with the Lord. As of this moment, last night, yesterday, last week, last month, throughout the pandemic, wherever that you know, remember them. And may that the Lord bless you and bless them as they rest in peace. Oh, gracious and loving God, we come before you this morning. Continue to give thanks to you for your Son, Jesus Christ. His death and resurrection that gave us hope and peace. We stand before you and in the midst of our church family. Ask for wrongdoing. When we are yet sinners, you sent your son Jesus Christ to die for us, and we believe and put our faith and trust in him and him alone. Hear our prayers with names of those that we care so deeply, those who are struggling with health issues. Touch them, O Lord. Give them strength, peace, and surround them with your presence, O Lord. Let them know you are with them in the midst of struggles, suffering, loss of a loved one. We pray especially for the people of Ukraine, people of Myanmar, the Philippines, Africa, and throughout the world, O Lord. We all call upon your name, the Most High, the Alpha, the Omega, the Most Powerful. You raise the dead. I know, Lord, that you hear our prayers and touch them. Protect, comfort. Oh, Lord, we pray for our congregation, for those who are not with us, our children, our homebound members. May your grace and your love upon each and every one of them. Sometimes we are more like Thomas. We doubt, which is the way that we try to find out the truth. And we are so grateful that you came to show to Thomas and the rest of the disciples that you truly alive and live. So we give thanks to come, Holy Spirit, come. On this bright Sunday, let us have the joy of Easter as we sing, as we pray, as we hear your word. Bless us, O Lord, in our service, so we may go from here and be a blessing to others, be the light and the salt, to bring joy and bring the good news that Christ is risen. He is risen indeed to the world. We pray all this in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, who taught us and his disciples when to pray we must say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
In our scripture reading, we're going to divide it into three parts. We're going to read the first part as Jesus appears to his disciple. We'll sing the first hymn. Then we'll go to the second part of the John chapter 20, Jesus appears to Thomas. Then we'll sing the second hymn. Then we'll read the last few verses, the purpose of John's gospel. And then we'll sing last hymn that we're going to sing today. But in between, if you wanted to share a humor, holy jokes, you may do so. So, I'm so grateful to have Beverly back to being a liturgist. So yes. It's good to see you there, Beverly.
Thank you.
Okay, yes.
The scripture this morning is taken from the book of John, chapter 20. And the verses 19 to 31, and I will read the first portion. It's when Jesus appears to his disciples. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the disciples were together, with the doors locked for fear of the Jewish leaders, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and sighed. The disciples were overjoyed when they saw the Lord when they saw the Lord. Again, Jesus said, "Peace be with you. Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, I am sending you." And with that, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive anyone's sins, their sins are forgiven. If you do not forgive them, they are not forgiven." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
If you want to stand for our first hymn.
No, we don't stand. We don't stand.
Okay.
Well, but you can stand if you're able.
Yeah, that's too much standing.
Oh, okay. Martha wants to say something. The hymns, the words will be on the screen. Oh, I'm sorry. We already picked three hymns, but I'm sure we may have a chance to sing your hymn.
Okay.
Here I am, Lord. You stand if you're able. So let's sing.
So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the nail marks in his hands and put my finger where the nails were and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were in the house again, and Thomas was with them. Though the doors were locked, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here. See my hands. Reach out your hand and put it into my side. Stop doubting and believe." Thomas said to him, "My Lord and my God." Then Jesus told him, "Because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed."
This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. 308, if those at home have a hymnal. Recorded in this book, but these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that by believing you may have life in his name. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Okay, our next hymn is Up from the Grave He Arose. It's number 322 in your hymnal. We'll sing verses 1 and 3.
Thank you.
went on a vacation to the Holy Land, and while they were there, the mother-in-law passed away. The undertaker told them, you can have her ship home for $5,000, or you can bury her here in the Holy Land for $150. The man thought about it for a while and told the undertaker, you would just have her shipped home. The undertaker asked, why would you spend $5,000 to ship your mother-in-law home when it would be wonderful to be buried here and spend only $150? The man said, a man died here about 2,000 years ago, and he was buried here, and 3 days later, he rose from the dead. I just can't take that chance. Tom?
Holy humor. Seems the pastor was having some problems with his car, and he took it to a mechanic, and he remarked to the mechanic, please don't be too hard on me. I'm just a poor preacher. And the mechanic says, yes, I know. I've heard you.
Anybody else? I share a very short message, and then you continue. Well, from our reading this morning, it's later in the evening on the same day that Jesus rose from the dead. Remember, Jesus appeared to the women, to Mary Magdalene, as we talked about it last Sunday. The question, why Jesus appears to the women first? Because they spread the news faster. So this evening, they're all still in the room, locked door, fear, confused, and doubt. And all of a sudden, Jesus stood in their midst. This is an invitation to all of us. If you imagine the disciples probably sitting around the tables or by the fireplace, and all of a sudden, Jesus showed up. Many of us hide in our own space with whatever that's going on in our lives. We're not able to share with anybody. With our doubt, with our fear, with our sin, or whatever the situation that you may encounter, that you wanted to hide and just to be alone, to be with your comfort zone, in your comfort zone with the people that you want to be with. And here Jesus appeared to them. Most all the time, Jesus wanted to come to you, to invade that space, to be with you. I know that we're so familiar with being quarantined these last 2 years, being in our own home with our own family, hardly going to any place. But Jesus is being with you. Amen? And I'm sure that the disciples say, Jesus, can't you knock before you walk in? Or have something to let us know that you're coming? But I'm sure Jesus said, I told you so. After 3 days, I'll be here. Yes, death does not have the last word over God. For God always has the last word for all of us. The disciples were surprised. And Thomas later came and witnessed that truly my Lord has risen. Yes, we know that Jesus has a sense of humor. And he is a practical joke that we know when Jesus show up to his disciples. They may be hiding, lock the door, turn off the light. We don't want anybody to know that we're here. But Jesus can come anytime, any place, no matter how sad, how hard, how difficult life is for all of us. Jesus is willing to come to you, to be with you in that space, in that point of life where you don't want anybody. Jesus will come to you. And when Jesus showed up to his disciples, and Thomas witnessed also, and Thomas said, I have seen the Lord. You are my Lord and my God. With that, I have a little video that will show us Jesus has a sense of humor. Yes, he has jokes for all of us too. So if Diane just showed this little video, you can press play, I think, in the corner. Sometimes we say that Thomas is the doubter. He doesn't believe that Jesus is risen until he sees or touched. But I think those are the questions that we actually ask, and it's good for us to ask those questions. And of course, Jesus returned after 8 days to be with his disciples, including Thomas, so Thomas can witness and all of us can witness too from what disciple have witnessed that early morning. We all wanted to touch and feel, but truly, the resurrection is the truth that Jesus raised from the dead. What is our response to Jesus' invitation to all of us? To just put our faith and trust in him. And Jesus said to Thomas, blessed are those who believe without seeing. We're here. We'll walk by faith, but not by sight. And Christ has risen to give us that hope for salvation and eternal life. Amen. Amen. Now, I invite you to prepare ourselves, to give ourselves our time, our service, our gift to honor Christ. Thanks to God.
Thank you.
2,000 meals, and those meals, I don't even remember the menu, but those meals nourished me, strengthened me every day. Without those meals, I may not be here. Go now. May the power of the resurrections nourish you, strengthen you, encourage you. give you peace, hope, and love. Just have faith and trust in Jesus. We don't want to wait to see, to believe. We are Easter people. We believe in Jesus, the Son of God. His Holy Spirit is with us. Go now. God be with you till we meet again. Amen.
Amen.